Want to get consistent, great exposure? Some say you need an agent, but all you really need to do is look at the mountains. Aren't they pretty? Yep, that's right. Just a quick glance at the mountains and you'll have all the information you need. Come on. Hi, Eric from Canon USA here, and welcome to the next episode of Quick Tips. Today, we'll be looking at those mountains as a means to figure out how to get great exposure from your digital camera. So you may ask, Eric, how's that work? Well, it's all about a tool in your camera called the histogram. Now, histogram, right? Sounds complicated. It's not as bad as it sounds. Some say histogram, schmistogram, who needs it? My exposures are fine. Sure about that? Histogram might even sound like something you go see your doctor about because it kind of looks like an EKG. The histogram is nothing more than a graphical representation of the tonal values in any given picture, and they kind of look like this. The graph reveals a range of tones that exist in your image. Let's just forget about color for a moment and pretend you're taking a black and white photo. Everything on the far left side of the graph represents dark tones. Everything on the right, your lighter tones. And of course, you guessed it, the mid-tones lay right there in the middle where you would expect them. The relative height of these mountains is irrelevant. It just means that the higher the mountains are, the more pixels there are at that particular tone. If I accidentally overexpose an image, meaning too bright, you might see the histogram data extend beyond the right side of the graph. In simplest terms, it's basically a warning saying that I'm losing printable detail in the highlights, and those mountains that extend beyond the right side will be pure white without detail. There's another cool tool in the blue playback menu called Highlight Alert, AKA the Blinkies. Now, this tool alerts you of any potential blowout of exposure by blinking in the affected areas when you're reviewing your image. On the opposite side of the histogram, in another example, if I underexpose an image to the point where the data extends beyond the left side of the graph, the image is losing printable detail in the deep shadow areas. It's within these areas you'll likely see a phenomenon called digital noise. It looks like sandy grit in your photograph and is a telltale sign your image is underexposed or too dark. It's one of the major areas that digital noise lives. One misnomer I'd like to clear up right now is that histograms should extend from one side of the graph all the way to the other. If your histogram looks like that, it simply means your image has a wide range of tones from highlights, midtones, and shadows. And it kind of looks like the one you see here. Now let's take a look at this picture of an egg against a white background. All the tones are on the lighter side, so the mountains will appear on the right side of the graph. This is completely normal, and you'll see the exact opposite when I painted the egg black against, and I put it against a black background. All the tones will be on the opposite side. To see how histograms react in real time, turn your live view LCD screen on and touch the info button until you see the live histogram appear on the overlay of the scene. As you change exposure, you'll see the data move to the right if you add more exposure and to the left if you decrease your exposure. So we now know that dark tones should appear towards the left side of the graph. If you see them creeping towards the middle, there's a good chance you're overexposing the scene, so you may simply want to decrease the exposure and watch the data of the histogram shift back to the left where it should be. The same exercise can be done for the highlights, but remember to keep the data or the tones from falling off the right side of the graph so you don't lose that printable detail. To review the histogram for each photo, touch the play button, that's the blue triangle button on the back of your camera, and you'll see, as you push the info button, you'll see the histogram appear for that individual image. Occasionally, in a high contrast environment like a sunny day, you may have very bright or dark objects in your photo, which may cause the histogram data to extend beyond one side or the other of the graph. You have to determine whether those tones are important to you or not. An example would be the sun. Under normal circumstances, you're never going to get detail on the sun. It's simply too bright. So that small spike where the sun would be is likely going to extend beyond over to the right side of the graph where you can see it. Histograms are a great way to get reliable exposure information, but because LCD displays vary slightly from camera to camera, it's best not to rely on them alone to gauge your exposure accuracy. At the end of the day, histograms are the best way to warn you of potential exposure issues. So if you want to up your game, start looking at your histogram and you'll be well on your way to getting great exposure. Hopefully this clears up any confusion you may have had about histograms. But if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll do our best to get back to you. Now, aren't you glad you didn't have to go see your doctor about that histogram? Until next time, get out there, start practicing, and stay tuned for more quick tips in this series right here. So long, everybody.